In this short video, I'm just going to show you in a little bit more detail how to code some of the question types I showed you in part three. Here on the screen, we have an example XLSForm, which will be partnered with this project that you will be able to download. You see at the top here, we've included a few metadata questions, including a start time, end time, and today. Before officially starting the survey, we have a note explaining a little bit more about it. This does not require any input, simply just some text in the label with a note in the type column and a name. For our first question itself, we have included a text question. This will accept any text as an input. Specifically, we are asking for the user's name, and we have made this required, therefore it cannot be left blank. Next, we ask for their user's birth date using the date question type. Then we use our first example of a multiple choice question with a select underscore one. Note that we have included gender in the type column. This is because this is the name of the list of answers we want to appear with the question, which can be seen on the choices sheet. We see at the top, we have a list called gender with three options, male, female, and other. Underneath this, we have a geopoint question, which will take the coordinates of the data collection site. We've also included a select underscore multiple as well as a select underscore one, this time using the list countries as the list of answer choices. You also notice with these two questions here, they have included a hint as well as the label. It's the little bit of extra text generally used as an instruction, which will appear under the main text label. If we go down slightly, you'll also be able to see that we have included a calculate-based question called holiday.uptake. Calculates are a very useful and flexible question type that I highly recommend you use. You'll notice while we've given it a name, we have not given it a label. It's because it is an internal calculation, which is not displayed to the user. In this example, we are seeing the difference between how many trips somebody took last year to how many trips they intend to take in the next 12 months. Therefore, we are subtracting question 7 from question 8 to see what the difference between the two numbers is. And then finally, you'll see that we've done a few extra select ones. I hope you've enjoyed this video. And in the next presentation in part 4, I'll be going over to a bit more of the form logic, and I will similarly do another video explaining a bit more of the things you can see here, such as the grouping and the repeats, as well as the constraints and skip patterns. Thank you for listening, and see you next time.